In today's video, I'm going to teach you how to make this isometric, stacked letter design in Adobe Illustrator. It's really quite simple actually, and it's very rewarding, and it's a neat technique you can add to your arsenal of graphic design techniques. As a graphic designer, it's crucially important to have a space on the internet to showcase your portfolio of work. Bookmark offers a straightforward and an easy to use website solution where you don't even need to type out a single line of code. Check out Bookmark linked down in the description box below and design your website today. So firstly, we obviously need some text, so press T for the type tool and then choose any letter that you want to be using for your design. Now press Command or Control T to bring up the character window. And for my design, I'm going to use aileron for the actual letter. And you want to use a thick and a bold kind of font, so I'm going to go for a black from the font family. We then need to come and outline the text by creating outlines here. So we now have a vector shape instead of a textual font. Next, we want to rotate the letter by minus 45 degrees, so do make sure to type in negative 45 if you want to rotate your shape in the same way that I'm going to. Next, open up the transform window and we're going to adjust the height settings to create the isometric style. You want to change the height to 57.74% and then just hit enter. So we have the base for the isometric lettering, and now we need to bring it down and then hold down the Alt or the Option key and click and drag to duplicate it upwards. Whilst you still have the keys held down, also hold down Shift so you keep things completely parallel and straight. Then release the keys and then press Command or Control D three more times so you have five shapes generated like so. We're now going to utilize Adobe Illustrator's built-in color themes, and if you don't have CC or you don't have this, then you're just going to have to create the colors yourself. But find a color scheme that you want to use, and then just apply the colors. So you need to select your shape, and then select the color. And then come down to here to actually apply the color to the shapes. I love this color theme setting and it really does help to choose awesome and neat color schemes. I'm actually going to make the top F gray for now and I'm going to continue to add the colors to the rest of the design. As you can see, my color scheme is quite pastel in nature. And that's what I want to use for my design, but you can use anything you want. You know, you can go for vibrant colors or even a monochrome. So now select all of the shapes and just press Command or Control 2, which is going to lock them down. Then press P for the pen tool and carefully draw in a shape here. And then draw in some more shapes here. But next, we're going to make use of a light source to create a more 3D feel for our design. So press V to select off of the pen tool path. Then I'm going to imagine some light coming from the left hand side of the screen. So I'm going to make this one here a bit lighter. And we can do that by just dragging the slider down in the color window. So all of the same side on my letter, I'm going to create in the same kind of lighter color, which does give the 3D effect to the design. Now this is looking pretty neat, as you can see. And because the shapes are locked, you're going to need to press I for the eyedropper tool to sample the next color for your design. And when you're actually drawing in the tricky parts here, it might be a good idea to press Command or Control Y to enter into outline mode so you keep things really, really precise and neat for your design. And then press Command or Control Y to enter back out of outline mode. So here is my design and all the shapes are still locked down. So hold down the Alt or the Option key, as well as Command or Control, and then press 2 to unlock everything. And I'm actually going to change the gray shape to the same purple that I've been using for the upper layers of the design. And I think I'm going to go for the lighter shade because the light obviously is coming from the top left. We've actually come to the end of the tutorial, but I did notice that it's a different way to do things, and I noticed it after I finished the design. Basically, what you want to do is you want to make this first letter like we did in the tutorial. Then you want to hold down the Alt or the Option key, click and drag downwards whilst holding Shift. And then with that selection still highlighted, send it to the very back of all layers. Then it's just a case of selecting one side and then holding down Shift again to select the same kind of colors. Then you just come to the color palette and change the color of that side. Now for the remaining sides, again use Shift and click select all of them, then press I for the eyedropper tool and sample the first color, and then just change it to a darker shade. You would then repeat this process downward until you're finished with the isometric stack letter. But yeah, I really like this design. I think it's something you can incorporate into various different designs. I actually have a few other isometric tutorials, which I'm going to post at the end of this video and also down in the description box below. If you want to keep boosting your skills and your awareness as a graphic designer, subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Like and share my videos on social media, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.